Hello, everybody. So today we are going to continue the academic writing. We talk about paragraph format, okay? And so far we have learned the definition of the academic writing. What is academic writing? How is it different from personal writing and creative writing? Okay, I hope that you are clear with the difference. And then we learn about the paragraph format and organization and capitalization. And then the last point that we are discussing right now is sentence structure. And of course, we focus only simple sentence, which consists four main elements, right? Subject, verb, compound subject plus verb, subject plus compound verb, and compound subject plus compound verb. So as a student of academic writing, you should be clear with grammar, okay? So because without grammar, you will make a lot of mistake when writing. And we already discussed the simple sentence, and this is the exercise. And I forgot another point, that is a subject verb agreement, right? It's another important grammar point. Subject verb agreement, and this is the exercise for you. Editing practice: find and correct 6 errors in subject verb agreement in the following paragraph. Young gold stars. Okay, so just try to find and correct the 6 errors in subject verb agreement. Okay. As an example, Gaul is no longer the sport of rich, middle-aged wise men. Young people around the world is taking up the game. Some of them is taking it over. One of the young star Seagulls Garcia. As you can see, when we reading, when we're trying to go through with the short paragraph, we can see young people around the world is. So problem, you can see the problem, right? One of the young stars, this is another kind of problem. So I hope that it's not something difficult for you to do. So I will leave it for you to try to find and underline the sentence error and try to correct them. Can you do that, right? Okay, now move to the last point of our grammar, fragments. Yeah, so what is fragment in your mind, in your ideas? What is fragments? Okay, fragment is a piece of sentence, just piece or part of the sentence. Usually we have learned simple sentence, subject, verb, and complement or object. But so when we are talking about fragments, you know, the sentence contain only verb, complement without subject, or sometimes have subject but without verb. That is we call fragment. In some languages, you can sometimes leave out the subject in a sentence. In others, you can sometimes leave out the verb. In English, you must always, you can see the word always. So be careful with this. Always, 100% have at least one subject and one verb in every sentence. If you leave out either the subject or the verb, your sentence is incomplete. Can you underline the word incomplete? Yeah? We call an incomplete sentence a fragment. incomplete sentence is called a fragment. Yes, these are fragments. Fragments are sentence errors. Biệt tha fragment nó cứ miền này tha bị yếu tại vì khó và vì ở trong tới từ tam vị cổ bật verb rồi cổ bật subject đôi tên này không bị yếu đang hỏi. As an example, it's not easy to get an A in Professor Wilson's class. So without subject, there is no subject. So you can see people in New York always in a hurry. Where is the verb? No verb. So to correct sentence one, add a subject. It is not easy to get an A in Professor Wilson's class. To correct sentence two, add verb. People in New York are always in a hurry. I hope you get it, right? So this is under the explanation of some vocabulary, phrasal verb, taking up mean learning, okay? Taking it over mean take control over it. There is one exception to this rule in commands, I just stop that and listen carefully. The subject you is not expressed. So in command, okay, as a dương gì không ai dương phải tha ví dụ mình chia dùng chia đôi sao kia đã sắp chết đôi sao tới sắp chết những dương score lại u thọ tha khi ông gì tới căn câu sơ tiếng anh được không thắc stand up please be careful the principal will come to see her so be careful you have to sit in a row okay. Listen carefully, you see, you have to listen carefully. Yeah, so non-pyo command. Okay, now move to practice four about fragments. Before you need to practice this, you have to read step one, two, three to understand what they allow you to do, the exercise, the practice. Step one, read each sentence and decide if it is a complete sentence or fragment. Mark the fragments with an X to show that it is incorrect. Decide what is wrong with each fragment. Is the following missing? Is the subject missing? Correct each fragment by adding a subject or a verb. Okay, do you understand what you are going to do? For example, very hot today, even with the windows open. Như ta thay nên cái đau á, xong bây đập bao phần ôi giới của nơi thật cái đau, nâng trong miền này chẳng. So it is very hot today, even with the windows open. Chosen Jin, the smartest students in the class. Bắt ấy đứa bốn. So Joe and Jin are the smartest students in the class. Okay, chỉ cần nghe suy tế, chẳng chờ tụi bay ôn thuở luôn ấy. So they are very easy, right? And something you don't understand, of course you can write me comment or give me the question, and I will immediately respond to you. Or I will make a short video answer your question. Okay, move to B, editing practice. Find and underline five fragments in the following paragraph. Then correct each one. My best friend. So what you have to do, find and then underline here, five fragments. Okay, so then after that, correct each one here. My best friend is Suzanne. We have been friends in childhood. As children, we live next door to each other in Caracas. Now live, in different country on different continents. She is married to Wayne Zulan, has three children. See, her son 2 years old, a twin daughter 3 months old. We haven't seen each other for 8 years. We keep in touch by email, also telephone each other at least once a month here. We will be friends forever. Okay, I hope you can do this. And okay, let us try to check the writing process overview. Dùng mơ overview, ca rùm lực tru tru lang vĩnh. Writing is never a one-step action. Dùng mơ ca tử xế, mình men chia sẽ cầm một phiếp tại mùi đi, tại sắp tầm mùi đi. Mình dừng tử xế hỏi hào gì mẹ nè. It is an ongoing creative act. Vì cứ chia ca sử xế, bà gọp ra ca chân này, bà đất bà tò bà tòp. Yeah, act nâng dìa sẽ cầm một phiếp tử xế á, dừng but corrective ongoing ongoing mean continuous. When you first write something, you have already been thinking about what to say and how to say it. Then after you have finished writing, you read over and lang vinh what you have written and make changes and corrections. Did you do that? Do you do that every time you have written a paragraph or you have written something or making sentences or just a short paragraph? Dừng thử thua ấy, if you say, hãy cái, hãy make change. Thôi cắt lạc đồ. Việt Nam trầm trời lạc đồ, hãy cái về. You write and revise. And write and revise again until you are satisfied that writing process is exactly what you want to say. Okay, the process of writing has roughly 4 steps. You can see 4 steps. Can you underline and try to learn the 4 steps of the writing process? In the first step, you create idea. Okay, create idea, first step. In the second step, organize ideas. Can you underline this? Third step, you write a rough draft. Do you understand the word rough draft? Priêng, mình toàn vô đấy. Vì cách ca là dùng priêng tốt, you have rough draft. In the final step, you polish your rough draft by editing it and making revisions. Revise, rum lực on make revision. Edit tăng cư dân cài vi edit via thơ mấy. Step 1, pre-writing. So, môn nâng dân hiện bi 4 step on thử underline via. Thời trần nam chia nẹ writing, môn nâng bổn dân thử phơi khla. Miền cầm nít thử organize via, hơi thử xe, hơi thử edit. Make change correction. Revision vậy thì dân trời thử chẳng hãy trong cõi này viên miền lạc nạ dùm khăn đòi xa tại phôn chia nẹ trời riêng được xế chẳng phôn ly trong mấy dùm khăn châu không dùm hư tạch tạch máu đảm bày nghị chạm ở vậy cái đó tập ôn ban chạm hồi vì stuart chùm nến cứ môn nâng phôn chạp ram phương kịch ca tử xế ấy mũi cứ dân bà con năng nâng đào tam cầm ru nâng ngày. Giờ mới step 1, pre-writing. The first step is called pre-writing. Pre-writing is a way to get idea. Đảm bây ai tựa ban cầm nít, miên cầm nít á, dương thật tạm miên nè, pre-writing, tựa xê đôi, tựa xê môn nâng tựa xê, cách ca môn nâng tựa xê, thật kết bị ảnh là. In this step, you choose a topic and collect idea to explain the topic. In chẳng đảm bây, ở miền cầm nít dương pra listing về miền trần là bài nữa list the idea on thằng học nếu có biết lý nữa dương lý tre môi mà there are several techniques you can use to get ideas. In the chapter you will practice the technique called listing. Dương chẳng nắm tha đam bay tattoo cầm nít dương pra pre writing nữa môn là dương phải máy dương tham môn nâng tự xe môn nâng xe cái dương para listing list via idea mùi mùi mà nâng cả support topic của dương listing is a pre-writing techniques as you can see and which you write the topic at the top of a piece of paper and then quickly make a list of the words or phrases that come into your mind. Don't stop to wonder if an idea is good or not. Write down, keep on writing until the flow of ideas stops. In the following example, the assignment was to write a paragraph about a person who has made a difference in the world, in the community, or in the writer's life. First, the writer made a list of people who have made a difference. Then he decided which person to write about and circle his choice. So a person who made a difference, as you can see, Albert Einstein, Mother Teresa, Martin Luther King, Cesar Chavez, Bill Gates, Ann Sarah, Mr. Jack Colson, and grandfather. So the last one, I choose grandfather. So those people have made a difference, right? ធ្វើឲ្យមានការផ្លាស់ប្ដូរនៅក្នុងធ្វើឲ្យមានការផ្លាស់ប្ដូរទៅធំនៅក្នុងពិភពលោកឬក្នុងសង្គម made a difference បាទអញ្ចឹងគាត់លីសយកមើលលីសមនុស្សមួយចំនួនហើយចុងក្រោយគាត់សម្រេចយក grandfather. Next, the writer started a new list. He wrote his chosen topic grandfather. You see the list grandfather, uneducated high school, eighth grade, farmer, work hard, help his community, started community hospital, respected in community, went to church every week, get up early, work late, was the first person in town to buy a car, forward thinking. So all of this we call listing. And after that, some idea are not related. Yeah, you when you start writing, you may pick up only 3 or 4 or 5 idea to write about your grandfather. So you just pick up the main point, right? And then try to support the main point. The writer then look at the second list and decide to write about how his grandfather helped his community. He circled that idea, then he thought about how his grandfather helped his community. He circled 2 ideas and marked them A and B. The writer also crossed out anything that didn't belong to these 2 ideas. So as you can see, right? They just pick up this, A and B. Try out. You write assignment at the end of the chapter will be to write a paragraph about a person who has made a difference in the world, in his or her communities, or in his life. Use the listing technique to choose a person. And a second list, write down the ways in which this person made a difference. Choose 1 or 2 ways to write about and circle them. You know, I will ask you to write a person who made a difference. So for your own idea. So do you think your father, your mother, or your relative, or who else that made a difference in your community? So this is I will set as your homework to do. Step 2, organizing. The next step in writing process is organize the idea. Why you need to organize the idea? To make it flow, right? Main idea, grandfather health community. Below the first sentence, he listed the 2 main ideas and any other words and phrase from the list that gave more information about them. So here, my grandfather helped his community in 2 ways. My grandfather, if you call topic, and help community in 2 ways, that if we call topic sentence. So below, I will the reader will wait to hear 2 ways that your grandfather help his community? Number A, as you can say, the first way, he improved farming techniques in his area. And then this is the port sentence, supporting sentences. And then for the second way, he started a community hospital, only hospital in big area. So I hope that you understand how you can organize your idea with the main idea and with the supporting sentences. This is the main idea and with the supporting sentence. Okay, so step three, writing. The next step is to write a rough draft. So after you get your listing, you know, organize the idea, then you have to write a rough draft using your outline as a guide. Write your rough drafts as quickly as you can without stopping to think about grammar, spelling, or punctuation. Can you underline this? Grammar, spelling, and punctuation. Just get your ideas down on paper. You will probably see many errors in your rough draft. This is perfectly usual and acceptable. After all, this is just a rough draft. You will fix the errors later. Cái dừng cái cầm hôn nó bị cào. Chẳng, sầm khán chi yếm prang tử xe ra trang năng xe để bàn trang máu. Hay là đại vì idea là vì mình connect with each other, dừng cross out chào. Okay. This one, dừng bàn riêng rồi ấy ná. Nâng dừng bàn tận prai khmai màu tiết. Chia paragraph cầm rú. Hay, The step four, polishing, revising, and editing. On bài biển này, on tình tình ở chăm. Riêng từ xe, riêng prao vía. Polish. Polish bà sân thì dương thưa ấy mối cứ dương đọc khát á. Khát vía ở lỗ ngoài xa đó, dương polish. Dương paragraph đôi khi dương à nói tầm bài thua vía ở xa đó. Ở lỗ, ọt chi kia để nẹ đại miên, nẹ đại từ xe hơi ọt khoa nâng polish. Poly hay dương revise, revising mơ viết tiết, lực mơ viêm, check mơ viêm. Biện nàng đại pra nó không contact nâng xăm xăm. Hay editing. Editing dương ai mất phẹt dương, dương hay peer editing. Chuối mơ môn nâng submit cho đại your teacher or professor. On page 198 or 207, worksheet for each chapter to help you polish your writing. The first worksheet is for a peer editor to use. A peer editor is a classmate who reads your paper and helps you improve the content and organization. Peer content nó mean là at the nay organization nó cứ bài bọt biết bọt để dùng to say nè. Okay, lý do mơ là biếm để kết vừa nè. Mật phẹt để dùng à vô từ chuối cái cứ cần dừng cài bẹp nặng đó, ao dự bò tam nặng, ok, hỏi từ xe sầm rạch, lấy nước đôi xa dừng bàn prai ruột hỏi chứng top pin nặng ấy dừng miên cell editing điện, mất thẻ cài hỏi dừng vô một cài sầm rạch trong cày này final copy chỉnh máu phần nặng, xin không tha bong pon rồi có bong pon này tặng on này điện check mơ biểu bọc nâng đảm bày cho bác lúa hay bí step môi tới step môi xâm khánh tôi chìm văn pháp nâng đi chìa review thế dường anh mơ review về lãng vinh của bán. These are important points covered in this chapter. Very important point in this chapter. Dường mơ hãy point môi môi để dường anh chăm bán thế. This is writing assignment. Assignment cho nâng the person who made a difference tại địch quân rồi có bọn bọn ai vô topic nẹ na của bán dương trọng dương bì ba phục bỏ dương rồi có nẹ na đầy made a difference in your community. Mì riêng nâng dương chọc bằng nâng. Ok. So that's all. So next class, I'm going to continue to the narrative paragraph, paragraph two, chapter two. I hope that you will join my class and pay attention to my listen to my video from the beginning to the end. Thank you.